So far, 2021 has been a pretty ruthless year. Not just because of the ongoing pandemic, but also because of the staggering amount of actors and actresses who have tragically passed away. We're here to let you know about some of the stars we've lost. On April 16, 2021, the New York Post reported that actress Helen McCrory died at the age of 52. Her husband, Damian Lewis, tweeted the news. "I'm heartbroken to announce that after a heroic battle with cancer, the beautiful and mighty woman that is Helen McCrory has died peacefully at home, surrounded by a wave of love from friends and family." According to the New York Post, McCrory began her work in the arts when she studied at the Drama Center in London. She won roles in various stage productions, but moved over to film and TV in 1994, first appearing in the movie Interview with a Vampire. Though she also appeared in many hits like Peaky Blinders and the James Bond flick Skyfall, the British actress is perhaps best known for her work as Narcissa Malfoy in Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. Her husband's tweet continued, "She died as she lived, fearlessly. God, we loved her and know how lucky we are to have had her in our lives. She blazed so brightly." Joseph Siravo died at the age of 66 in April of 2021. His family confirmed his death in a statement to the New York Post, saying, "The acclaimed actor, director, and teacher died on Sunday, April 11th after a long, courageous battle with colon cancer." Siravo was most famous for portraying Tony Soprano's gangster father in The Sopranos.
"Not right now, Tony. You'll be good, though. Pay attention to what those teachers tell you, you hear me, Anthony?"
Nonetheless, he was a prolific actor with an expansive list of credits, including Law & Order and The People vs. O.J. Simpson: American Crime Story. However, it was the New York actor's stage work that is perhaps the most noteworthy. According to the New York Post, Siravo played more than 2,000 performances in the national tour of Jersey Boys and appeared in numerous other stage productions. Siravo's daughter, Allegra O'Carmes, wrote on Instagram, "I was by his side when my dear father passed away this morning. We are both so lucky to be so intensely loved. I am so immensely grateful to have had him here on Earth, and I know that he hasn't gone very far." Actor and rapper DMX, whose real name was Earl Simmons, died on April 9, 2021 after a drug overdose and subsequent coma. He was only 50 years old. His family released a statement to Page Six, writing, "We are deeply saddened to announce today that our loved one passed away at 50 years old at White Plains Hospital, with his family by his side after being placed on life support for the past few days." As noted by Page Six, DMX took the rap world by storm with his 1998 release It's Dark and Hell Is Hot, a rap album that topped the charts and went platinum nearly 5 times. He went on to release more rap albums and earn 2 Grammy nominations. He was also an actor with almost 60 credits in shorts, movies, and TV shows, including Belly, Romeo Must Die, and Fast and Fierce Death Race. His family statement continued, "Earl was a warrior who fought till the very end. He loved his family with all of his heart, and we cherish the times we spent with him. Earl's music inspired countless fans across the world, and his iconic legacy will live on forever." Paul Ritter, a British character actor, died in April 2021 from a brain tumor at the age of 54. Ritter's agent confirmed his death and revealed that he was with his family in his home when he died. With a long list of credits ranging from stage productions and sitcoms to famous miniseries and movies, Ritter and his talents will surely be missed. Ritter was most recently in the sitcom Friday Night Dinner and also appeared in other famous TV shows like Catherine the Great and the award-winning series Chernobyl. As far as films go, he appeared in hits such as the James Bond flick Quantum of Solace and Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. In addition to his screen work, Ritter was also an accomplished stage actor, snagging nominations for an Olivier Award and a Tony Award, according to The Guardian. Robert Popper, the creator of Friday Night Dinner, tweeted, "Devastated at this terribly sad news. Paul was a lovely, wonderful human being. Kind, funny, super caring, and the greatest actor I ever worked with." Deadline confirmed that Jessica Walter from Arrested Development died in her sleep on March 24, 2021. Walter's daughter, Brooke Bowman, released a statement, sharing, "A working actor for over six decades, her greatest pleasure was bringing joy to others through her storytelling both on screen and off. While her legacy will live on through her body of work, she will also be remembered by many for her wit, class, and overall joie de vivre." Walter did have a prolific career. In addition to her portrayal of Lucille Bluth in Arrested Development, she won hearts in big movies like Play Misty for Me, The Flamingo Kid, and Grand Prix, and memorably voiced Mallory Archer and Archer. Walter also won awards, scoring two Golden Globe nominations, three SAG nominations, three Emmy nominations, and one Emmy win for the lead role in Amy Prentice. Her Arrested Development co-star Jason Bateman tweeted, "What an incredible career, filled with amazing performances. I will forever remember my time with her, watching her bring Lucille Bluth to life. She was one of a kind."
Oh, stop being so dramatic.
As reported by the New York Post, actor George Segal died at the age of 87 on March 23, 2021. His wife, Sonia Segal, confirmed he died from complications from bypass surgery. While Segal had a long career on both stage and screen, he is best known for playing Nick in the movie version of Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf, a role that would win him an Oscar nomination. He was also nominated for three Golden Globes and took home two wins, one for A Touch of Class and another for The New Interns. More recently, Segal brought Albert "Pop" Solomon to life on the hit ABC sitcom The Goldbergs. Adam F. Goldberg, the series creator, tweeted his despair over the loss, writing, "Today we lost a legend. It was a true honor being a small part of George Segal's amazing legacy. By pure fate, I ended up casting the perfect person to play Pops. Just like my grandfather, George was a kid at heart with a magical spark." Actor Felix Silla was perhaps most famous for a role in which audiences never got to see his face or hear his voice, Cousin It on The Addams Family. Silla played the creepy family member for 17 episodes, stealing scenes with his floor-length hair, bowler hat, and incredible physical comedy. The actor also played an Ewok in Star Wars Return of the Jedi, made an appearance in the Star Wars spoof Spaceballs, and went unseen in other parts, like that of a robot on the TV show Buck Rogers in the 25th Century. Sadly, as reported by the New York Times, Silla died from cancer on April 16, 2021. He was 84 years old. He is survived by his wife and daughter. As reported by the New York Times, actor Charles Grodin died in May of 2021 at his home in Connecticut from bone marrow cancer. He was 86 years old. Grodin had a very successful acting career that he credits to the Elizabeth Taylor and Montgomery Clift movie A Place in the Sun. He told the Television Academy Foundation, "It was two things. One is I think I developed an overwhelming crush on Elizabeth Taylor. And two, Montgomery Clift made acting look like, well, gee, that looks pretty easy. Just a guy talking." While the All-American comedian had lots of roles in movies like Catch-22, The Heartbreak Kid, Heaven Can Wait, and Midnight Run, his most famous role was opposite a giant drooling dog in the family comedy Beethoven. Grodin also had a long list of Broadway credits, including the famous Bernard Slade play Same Time Next Year, according to the New York Times. The publication also noted that he had his own talk show, collected more than 70 appearances on other talk shows, and even won an Emmy for a television special. While most people remember him best as the bossy Jamaican crab Sebastian in Disney's The Little Mermaid, Samuel E. Wright was so much more than that. As reported by the New York Times, the prolific actor was in eight Broadway shows and originated the role of Mufasa in the stage musical The Lion King, for which he won a Tony nomination for Best Featured Actor in a Musical. But no one will ever deny how much he was loved for bringing Sebastian to life in The Little Mermaid and other spin-off movies, TV shows, and specials. Sadly, as per the New York Times, Wright died in 2021 at the age of 74 from prostate cancer. He told the Los Angeles Times, "Maybe not every actor would say this, but if I didn't want to be immortal, I wouldn't be acting. I do want to make my little mark on the world." Thanks to a singing cartoon crab and other memorable performances, he did. School of Rock actor Kevin Clark died after being hit by a car in May of 2021. As reported by Chicago Sun-Times, the former child star was riding his bike in the Northwest Side neighborhood of Chicago when he was hit. While paramedics took him to Illinois Masonic Medical Center, he was pronounced dead about an hour later. School of Rock co-star Miranda Cosgrove wrote on Instagram, "The world lost an amazing soul. I'll always remember your spirit and how kind you were to me. I'll never forget all the memories. You'll always be missed, Kevin." According to his IMDb page, School of Rock was the only movie Clark ever took part in. Subsequently, he turned his attention to music, writing songs, teaching kids at a School of Rock, and forming bands, according to the Chicago Sun-Times. The publication also reported that he'd recently started a new band that was gaining traction. His mother, Allison Clark, told the publication, "He told his bandmates just yesterday, 'You know, this is finally the life I want to live, and we're going to make it. You're my musical family, my family, and we're all going to make it.'" Actor Gavin McLeod, best known for The Love Boat and The Mary Tyler Moore Show, died in May of 2021. According to the New York Times, the exact cause of his death is unknown, but his nephew did confirm McLeod had been suffering from health issues before he died. As the New York Times also reported, the actor was almost 40 years old and seriously down on his luck when he auditioned for The Mary Tyler Moore Show in 1970. Though he was brought in for the role of Lou Grant, he asked if he could be considered for the role of Murray, which he booked. He went on to play Murray for 168 episodes of the comedy hit. McLeod wrote in his autobiography, "Murray represented all the brown baggers, not just in newsrooms, but in all sorts of professions. People felt they knew me." Right after The Mary Tyler Moore Show, McLeod scored the lead in The Love Boat, bringing Captain Steubing to life from 1977 to 1987. He also had credits in other TV shows like Perry Mason and Combat. Actress and model Romy Walthall died on May 19, 2021 from sudden cardiac arrest, as reported by Variety. She was 57 years old. Walthall's daughter wrote on Instagram, "I've resigned myself to the fact that there will never be any appropriate combination of earthly words to accurately describe my mother. She was the most beautiful woman I've ever seen, and she was wicked and fun and light and dark, and she possessed the kind of magic that you truly just don't see." According to Variety, Walthall got her start in the world of entertainment when she was just 17, working as a model in Europe. As per her IMDb page, one of her first movies was the thriller Thief of Hearts. She later found the horror genre suited her, as she went on to famously star in a number of horror movies, including Howling 4, The Original Nightmare, and The House of Usher. The 90s were an especially prolific time for her, as she piled up quite a list of credits in various TV series and the occasional blockbuster, such as the John Woo classic Face Off. The New York Times reported that actor Clarence Williams III died from colon cancer in early June of 2021 at age 81. Williams was one of the stars of Mod Squad from 1968 to 1973, making him one of the first black actors with a lead role on a TV show. The procedural followed three hippies who were arrested, only to find themselves on the other side of the interrogation table when they became plainclothes police officers. The intense, engaging actor perhaps drew on his time in the military for his role in Mod Squad, as, according to the New York Times, he was a paratrooper for the 101st Airborne Division before he fell into acting. Williams often performed on the stage, earning himself a Tony nomination for his work in Slow Dance on the Killing Ground. He also appeared in many movies from Purple Rain to Deep Cover, and had small roles on almost 40 other TV shows. Actress Tawny Kitaen died early May of 2021 at age 59, according to USA Today. While that publication reported her official cause of death was yet to be released, her brother told TMZ that he believes his sister died because she couldn't cope with the recent death of their father. Her children, Winter and Rain, wrote on Instagram, "We are heartbroken and saddened to announce the death of our mom. We just want to say thank you for always showing her such support and love. You gave her life every day. We miss her and love her, and we know her legacy will live on forever." Kitaen's most famous acting role was as Tom Hanks' fiancé in Bachelor Party, but she was also well known for starring in several music videos in the 80s, including Here I Go Again and Still of the Night by Whitesnake, and Back for More by Rat. Actor Ned Beatty died at age 83 from natural causes in June 2021, according to The Hollywood Reporter. Beatty is perhaps best remembered for his role in Deliverance, the Appalachian survival story that sent waves through Hollywood in 1972. However, as The Hollywood Reporter also stated, Beatty only got the role that made him famous because he flirted with another man's wife during a lunch. He told CBS, "I was quite the heel, and I think that's what director John Borman liked. He said he thought I was the rudest person he had ever met." Beyond Deliverance, Beatty also starred in movies like Mikey and Nikki, Shooter, and Charlie Wilson's War. The actor was also the voice of the villainous Lotso in Toy Story 3 and got an Oscar nomination for his very brief role in Network.
Why me?
Because you're on television, dummy.
If everybody loves Phil Rosenthal, the creator of hit sitcom Everybody Loves Raymond, then everyone really loves his father, Max Rosenthal. Rosenthal was a beloved actor, stealing scenes with a recurring role on his son's sitcom. But he was also beloved just for being himself, popping up in several episodes of the PBS show I'll Have What Phil's Having, and the Netflix hit Somebody Feed Phil, telling jokes and warming hearts. Rosenthal wasn't just a great actor and provider of jokes, he was also a Holocaust survivor. As reported by the New York Jewish Week, Rosenthal got out of Germany right after Kristallnacht, a night in 1938 during which Nazis burned Jewish property and killed around 100 people. The world lost a true treasure when, in June of 2021, Rosenthal died at the age of 95. His son wrote on Instagram, "As heartbroken as we are so grateful that he was our dad, our grandpa, our friend, our favorite and funniest TV star. You live on forever in us, your family, and the friends you've made around the world." While Suzanne Douglas had a long, successful career, she most recently fell into the public eye when she played Grace Cuffey in the Netflix hit When They See Us, a dramatic miniseries about the Central Park Five. She also starred in the sitcom The Parenthood from 1995 to 1999, as well as School of Rock and How Stella Got Her Groove Back. Sadly, Douglas's agent told USA Today that she died in early July of 2021, issuing a statement that read, "The industry has lost a truly gifted and talented artist. She touched everyone who knew her and was lovely in every sense of the word." The actress's PR representative later confirmed to USA Today that she died from cancer. She was 64 years old. When They See Us creator Ava DuVernay tweeted, "Suzanne Douglas was a quiet, elegant force. A gentlewoman, a gem of a lady, a confident, caring actor who breathed life into the words and made them shimmer. May she journey on in peace and love." Robert Downey Sr. died in his sleep in July of 2021. The Post details that Downey Sr. had been suffering from Parkinson's for several years and, quote, "remained remarkably optimistic throughout." Downey Jr. also called his father a true maverick filmmaker, as Downey Sr. worked in film for most of his life as both an actor and a director. According to Variety, the filmmaker directed the cult classic Putney Swope, a satirical dark comedy about an African-American activist who ends up in charge of a Madison Avenue ad agency. Downey Sr. also acted in a collection of hit movies like Boogie Nights, as well as several popular TV shows like The Twilight Zone and First and Ten. With over 120 acting credits to her name, it's easy to say that Olympia Dukakis was a legend. The actress's first on-screen role was in 1962 in the TV show The Doctors and the Nurses, and she went on to make appearances in big hits like Steel Magnolias and Moonstruck, for which she won the Oscar for Best Actress in a Supporting Role in 1987. According to the New York Times, Dukakis died in early May 2021 at the age of 89. She is survived by her three children and four grandchildren. She once remarked to The Guardian, "Maybe good fortune comes to you for the same reason as bad. You learn a lot of things when you're struggling, and other things when you're what the world calls successful. Or perhaps it's just something that happens. Some days it's cold and some days it's hot." According to E! News, comedian and actor Paul Mooney died at age 79 on May 19, 2021. His publicist said in a statement, "Paramedics tried unsuccessfully to revive him after he suffered a heart attack." She added that he had been, quote, "staying with a family member who was a caregiver and had declining health that came with age." Mooney was a successful writer, comedian, and actor with a career spanning more than 40 years. He acted in TV shows and movies like Hollywood Shuffle and Chappelle's Show. He was also a writer on big hits like The Richard Pryor Show, The Roseanne Show, and In Living Color. Stars took to social media to remember the comedian, with Viola Davis tweeting, "You were both funny and poignant. Rest well." Holly Robinson Pete wrote, "Few people made me laugh the way Paul Mooney did. He was a brilliant comedian and writer. You will be so missed." According to NPR, rapper and actor Biz Markie died in July of 2021 from an unknown illness. His manager told the publication that he'd been sick for months, but otherwise did not give a specific cause of death. He was 57 years old. Born Marcel Theo Hall, Markie took the hip-hop scene by storm for decades, especially with his 1989 smash single Just a Friend. In addition to being a celebrated rap artist, Markie was also a successful actor. His IMDb page lists 31 acting credits, including Men in Black 2, the popular children's series Yo Gabba Gabba, and the comedy show Crank Yankers, on which he was the announcer. As his manager told NPR, "Biz created a legacy of artistry that will forever be celebrated by his industry peers and his beloved fans, whose lives he was able to touch through music, spanning over 35 years. Saginaw Grant was a longtime actor famous for portraying Native Americans in movies and TV shows. Grant has acted since 1988 in over 50 projects, including hits like Breaking Bad. As reported by NPR, he was also the hereditary chief of the Sac and Fox Nation of Oklahoma and an avid participant in modern California powwow culture. The actor and activist even traveled around the world to help teach people about indigenous American culture. And as a veteran of the U.S. Marine Corps, he was also involved in the National Gathering of American Indian Veterans and worked to get Indigenous Americans recognition for their military service. Sadly, NPR reported that Grant died in his sleep of natural causes in July 2021. He was 85 years old. Lainey Carmichael, Grant's publicist, told the publication, "His motto in life was always respect one another and don't talk about one another in a negative way." As reported by Deadline, actor Trevor Moore died in early August of 2021. He was only 41 years old. As of the making of this video, there is little information about his cause of death, other than it was an accident. Moore was an actor, comedian, writer, and producer, best known for co-founding the sketch comedy group The Whitest Kids You Know. Some of his other credits include his Comedy Central show The Trevor Moore Show, The Midnight Show, and Just Roll With It. According to Deadline, Moore was also the world's youngest published cartoonist, as he published his cartoon book Scraps when he was only 12 years old. Moore is survived by a wife, Amy Carlson, and a son, August. His wife said in a statement, "He was known as a writer and comedian to millions, and yet to us, he was simply the center of our whole world. We don't know how we'll go on without him, but we're thankful for the memories we do have that will stay with us forever." According to the New York Times, British actress Una Stubbs died in Edinburgh in August of 2021 at age 84. Though Stubbs had a long and successful career, she was perhaps most famous for her portrayal of housekeeper Mrs. Hudson in the BBC's Sherlock, starring Benedict Cumberbatch. The sweet and sassy actress often stole the show as Mrs. Hudson, winning over the audience with her sarcasm and endless quips. Interestingly, Mrs. Hudson was a rather small character in the original Sherlock Holmes books, so Stubbs and the Sherlock team had the opportunity to get creative. The actress even drew from her own experiences as a mother for the character. She told the New York Times in a 2016 interview, "I am the mother of three sons, so I thought that would be a good angle to go on. I once told Benedict that my sons go straight to the fridge and make themselves sandwiches, and he did that in one episode." In addition to her work on Sherlock, Stubbs had a long list of credits, with roles on the likes of Dancing in Summer Holiday, Fawlty Towers, and Call the Midwife. According to the New York Times, actor Ed Asner died at the age of 91 on August 29, 2021. His family announced his death on Twitter, writing, "We are sorry to say that our beloved patriarch passed away this morning peacefully. Words cannot express the sadness we feel." Asner had over 400 acting credits from over 64 years in the entertainment business. Some of his last appearances were in Grace and Frankie, Cobra Kai, and Dead to Me. Asner was perhaps most famous for two roles. the grumpy yet adorable Carl in Up, and the flat yet hilarious Lou Grant in the Mary Tyler Moore Show and the spinoff Lou Grant. As reported by the New York Times, he was the first actor to win both comedic and dramatic Emmys for the same character, as he won multiple times for playing Lou Grant on the original show and the spinoff. Actor and comedian Tom Arnold wrote on Twitter, "My friend Ed Asner was everything I've always wanted to be. Actor, author, activist, warm, lovable, gruff, lefty, patriot, and a great father." Lastly, here are some more actors and actresses we've lost in 2021. Barbara Shelley, Richard Gilliland, Ernie Lively, Arlene Galanka, Lisa Barnes, Joe Lara, Daniel Mickelson, Jay Pickett, Jackie Mason, William Smith, Marky Post, Jane Withers.